intervened. She's in good spirits. She told them yesterday, she said, I'm a winner either way if I go or if I stay. She said, if I go to be with Jesus, I know he's standing there waiting for me. And my daddy's right there beside him saying, come on in, Rita, come on. She said, I'm just a winner either way. So she's got high spirits. She said, told the preacher, and I reckon it was the doctor, and told him that if something happened, she was ready to go. She didn't have no worries. She was ready to go be with the Lord. And that ought to be the main thing on our hearts. If we know beyond a shadow of doubt, if we leave this world, that we're ready to go. Because if we don't know, guess what? We got problems. We got problems. I was watching the news yesterday. I don't know if anybody else watches it or not, but I watched the news yesterday, and our president of the United States met with the teachers from Florida and places and the students, and he had a conference with them. But before he had that conference, he had a pastor to stand up and give prayer over that meeting before they even talked about anything. He give God the glory first. And he give God the honor. And I was proud of that. But we need to pray for our land and country. We need to pray for our schools. Pray for the teachers. Pray for the students that's in the schools. We need to pray for them. Because the devil is roaming to and fro, seeing whom he may devour. And if he can use a kid to do it, he's going to use a kid to do it. And we just need to pray for our schools. Anybody else tonight?
Remember the direction of the church?
And we'll follow the leading of the Lord, do what he has to do.
Remember all of our lost loved ones.
Remember,
amen. Spirit, Brother Josh.
Kayla said, remember Jackson in prayer, he has an ear infection.
Amen. Remember Jackson. Amen. Somebody else. Somebody else.
Remember me and Wayne and Craig, and remember Debbie Jesse's family. She lost her sister.
Amen. Remember that. Somebody else. Kenny's wife. She needs our prayers too. There's a lot of people that's told me that's got cancer that they need to pray for. I can't remember all their names because I had some people last night tell me about some people that need prayer for cancer. So, and I can't remember what their names was. Save my life. But God knows who it is. And they need to be prayed for. Cancer is rampaging. I mean, it seems like it's just getting, like it's just, and it's not letting them last long at all. It's like as soon as they find out, they're gone. So let's remember that tonight. Anybody else?
Remember Elijah and the two, both of
them sick. Amen. Remember that. Somebody else?
Y'all remember me and Tanya. Yesterday, and took our first foster parenting class. Start to foster parenting. I know everybody thinking, well, you got five, ain't that enough? But just it's something we've been talking about for a couple of years, and we just feel that God's saying it's time. So y'all just keep us in prayer with that. And also just remember all the churches everywhere really, but even here in just the community that You know, God will set up, you know, get them ashes going, blowing them ashes to get people's fire going, get them on fire for God. I went to a church here, or visited a church here not too long ago, recently, that they're one of the churches, they don't, you know, they don't really, they don't shout, they don't speak in tongues, they don't just fall out before, you know, they don't get slain, they don't practice that, they don't teach about that. They teach about love, and they teach about compassion, and they teach that, you know, make disciples of all nations, preaching the gospel of all nations. And you know that, and they practice. You know, they're very into their mission work. You know, in Africa and India, they do a lot of work in those two states, or those two countries. They also do a lot of work in Mexico. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. But we're not just called to preach about love and compassion and do missionary work. We're called to make disciples of all nations. We're called to preach the gospel from Genesis to Revelation. And in that, from Genesis to Revelation, there's also hellfire and brimstone that does not get preached on enough. Hell does not get preached on enough. You know, preachers might mention hell, but, you know, it's not like what is preached here, or, you know, some churches that I've been to. And, you know, I'm not saying that, you know, they're wrong in doing that. I'm not saying that they're going to hell because of that. I'm not saying that at all. It's just, we just need to be on fire for God. We need to, you know, like here, we need to preach the full gospel. And we do preach full gospel. But churches around the world need to realize, you know, there's more than just love and compassion. You know, there's the hellfire and brimstone that needs to be preached to, too. So just remember the church, the leaders of the church, remember them that they want to conform to the world. They won't let their church conform to the world. You know, it's one thing to let somebody that's living in the world come into the church, but, you know, it's another thing to let somebody that's living in the world and living in sin to come into the church, and then, you know, it just, that's what the church turns into. So just keep leaders of the church in prayer. And y'all just remember me and Tanya and our family in prayer. We'll just stay in the Lord.
Amen. Somebody else before we pray.
Trust the Lord to take care of all that. And also, I'm trying to give up something that's pretty big. It's been big. It's trying to hold on me for quite a few years. So y'all really pray that God will help me to overcome that as well.
Amen. Somebody else. Let's remember our land and country. Let's pray for our land and country. Pray for Jerusalem. The peace of Jerusalem. Pray for Israel. And let's just pray for the lost all over. I got lost loved ones. I know everybody else in here has got lost loved ones that needs to be saved. And some of us has got some in here that says that they're saved, but they don't live the life. We got to pray for them. We got to show them love. I was telling some people about us, about the church out here and how God's been blessing the church and been doing good. And I said, some nights on Thursday nights we don't have that many. I said, but some, you show me other churches that does. I mean, people will rush in, they'll fill them up on Sunday mornings, but Thursday nights and Sunday nights, seem like they get enough on Sunday morning. But we got to pray for them that God will give them that desire. The desire to be in the house of God. I appreciate the Lord. I love Him. You say, preacher, you're stern. Well, you got to be. The Bible tells us to be. We got to be. We can't play church. We can't patty the backs all the time, like Brother Wayne said the other night. You know, we can't just let them. They got to be here to learn. You got to be in the church to learn about God and to know that God is real. We need to pray for Sister Tanya. She's supposed to be having surgery on her leg, on her knee. So we need to lift her up in prayer tonight. She needs our prayers. So let's, tonight when we pray, be serious and say, God, you move upon these needs. You know each and every need. You know each and every request. Remember Ronnie Sossman. He needs our prayers. Edward Turner needs our prayers. The devil is really fighting him. And really fighting him hard. And it's depression has set in on you. And we got to pray for those people that God will reach down and touch them. But really be sincere when you say, God, I want you to move upon these needs. It's like our prayer box up here. It's got all kinds of needs in it. We don't know them needs, but God knows as soon as it was wrote on that piece of paper, he knows what them needs was. And so let's pray for it. Also pray for the church. Coming up in March, we're going to go on fast for the church. To get closer to God and for God to show us what he wants us to do in the church. Not only me and Nora and Wayne and Connie, but y'all. We got to show y'all what he wants y'all to do. How he wants y'all to get close to him. She said if we draw nine to him, he would draw nine to us. So if we don't draw nine to him, he's not going to get close to us. That's what that scripture was saying. If you'll draw nine to me, he said, then I'll draw nine unto you. In other words, he said, you get close to me, I'm going to get close to you. That's what we need. Anybody else before we go to prayer? Brother Josh.
Emmy says, pray for her daughter, Megan. She has strep throat and pray for her upcoming surgery. She has scoliosis and will be getting two rods attached to her spine.
Amen. Just remember that. Just remember that. That child is only what? 13? You're going to have back surgery. We know a God that can heal that back before she has to go have that done. Amen. Unspoken request by the raising of your hand. Pray at the altar or pray at your seat.
Bless the Lord God as I come to you, God. I thank you, God, for this day. And I thank you, Lord God, that you woke us up. And Lord God, that you allow us to live another day, God. And I just thank you, God, for being able to be in the house of the Lord. God, and I just pray, God, that I can draw nigh unto you, Lord God, so you can draw nigh unto me, God. God, because I want to do what you would have us to do, God. I want to be what you would have us to be, Lord God. God, as we pray for each need and each request, God, Sister Connie, Lord God, we ask God, Sister Bonnie, Lord, Sister Misty, Lord God, oh God, I pray, God, that you would move upon these requests, God, Brother Gavin, Lord. Oh God, I just pray, God, right now, God, that you would move, God, upon them, Lord God, you heard them, Lord God. Lord God, you seen the hands that went up, God, you know the needs of those hands tonight, God. Heavenly Father, God, I pray for my lost loved ones, God, but I don't just pray for my lost loved ones. I pray for everybody else's lost loved ones, God, that needs to be saved, Lord God. I pray for those that's got cancer tonight, God. I pray for those, God, but Lord God, that's in the hospital, God, that needs a touch, Lord. Sister Rita Walden, God, I pray, God, you touch her body, Lord God. I pray, God, you show them doctors a miracle in her, Lord. Heavenly Father, God, I ask you right now, God, in your son's name. God, I pray for Brother Edward Turner tonight. God, give him that peace that he needs, Lord. God, give him that assurance, Lord God. God, let him know, God, that he needs to walk upright close to you, God. Lord God, don't worry about things, but just give it to you and let you take care of it, Lord. Heavenly Father, I pray for Ronnie Sauston tonight, God. Lord God, you see his body, Lord God, you see, God, what the doctors have said is wrong with him, Lord. Stephanie Kelter, Lord God, I pray for her tonight, God. Oh, Heavenly Father, God, I pray, God. Oh, God, that you would move in this service tonight, God, not our will. How about your will be done in this place, God, I pray. Lord, that the people would get their minds upon you tonight, God. Lord God, and they would begin to worship you, Lord. I pray, God, for the peace of Jerusalem, Lord. I pray for Israel tonight, God, and I pray for our president and our vice president, Lord God. I pray, God, that you would help them. God, give them the courage and the strength to go on, that no matter what comes their way or what comes against them, I pray, God, that you give them that strength. I give them that wisdom, God, that they need, and the knowledge, God, to run this country the way that you would want it to be run, Lord. God, we ask you right now, God, we pray for our senators, our governors, and our Congress, Lord, our House of Representatives, God. Lord God, we pray for our Lord God, our city council members, Lord God, I pray that you save them most of all. Oh God, that you would get a hold of their hearts and let them realize, God, that there is a God in heaven. Oh God, I ask you right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray for those naysayers that's coming against our president or our vice president that talks about him because he talks to you, Lord God. I pray for their souls, Lord. I pray that you save them, God. I pray, God, move upon Emmy's little girl, God, you touch her. Lord God, you begin to heal that back. You straighten that back up, God. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, touch little Jackson's ears, Lord God. God, that ear infection, God, we come against it in the name of Jesus, Lord. God, we just give you praise. God bless our preacher tonight as they bring the word forth, God. God, we just ask it in your son's precious name. And we give you all the thanks and all the glory. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Mist, you ain't got one tonight. What about you, Michael? You got us one?
Not tonight, but we found the tape puller. It wasn't the little girls, it was the little boy. He just stood there and rolled some off a chair.
All right, Sister Connie, nobody else says they ain't got one, so I guess you'll have to sing this one or two.
Discouraged about love. for an answer. I know it's on its way. I'll keep holding on to all of my confusion.
Yes,
hallelujah. I don't understand the Lord. I'm not afraid.
Oh,
Are y'all here tonight or are y'all asleep? Man, I'm here to worship the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. I'm here to praise God tonight. Hallelujah. To make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord a great big hand tonight. That was here Sunday morning is still here tonight. The same one that was here on Sunday night, Brother Wayne, is still here tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now let's give the mother of the church, the first lady of the church, a big hand as she comes and brings forth the bread of life.
Of the Lord. You know, poor Miller said that. Are y'all awake and are y'all asleep and all this stuff? You know, it's been coming to me all service. If we got graded on our effort, our participation, our ability, if God came down like he did to Adam and Eve in the cool of the day, and he come down and he walked with us during this service,
yes,
and he graded us on everything that happened in this service, what kind of grade would we get?
Amen. Come on.
You know, what kind of grade would we get? I know people's tired. I know people is weary. But what kind of grade would we get? If Jesus came down and said,
come on.
You know, ain't I worthy to be lifted up?
Right.
Ain't I worthy to be praised? What kind of record, what kind of report card would we receive? You know, when you go to work, which some of us don't work now, but we worked. We wanted a good job. We wanted to try to do a good job because we didn't want nobody stealing our job.
Come
we didn't want somebody to do it better than us because we didn't want to lose our job. We didn't want to lose our paycheck.
Come on.
And if God came down and said, I'm going to grade you on this, and I'm going to grade you on that, and I'm going to grade you on this, and I'm going to grade you on that, what kind of grade would we get?
Come on.
What kind of grade would we get in our services that we have for participation, for being there, for willingness, for having our mind on Jesus, for having our mind on the service, for wanting to obey God and see people helped and see people delivered and see ourselves helped and see ourselves delivered.
Yes.
And I don't mean it in a bad way, but as I was sitting over there, it kept coming to me, what kind of grade? If we were graded on our performance, that we come in our services, if we were graded on our performance, if we were graded on our daily walk with Jesus, what kind of grade would we receive? Would we measure up? Would we get a grade good enough to go to heaven? Would we get a grade good enough to make it? Would we get a grade good enough? And it kept coming to me. It's violent, but I didn't know the song, but I would have sung it. I'll face nobody's record but my own. You can't blame it on somebody that I didn't participate, or I didn't do this, or I didn't do that. I'll face nobody's record but my own. When it comes down to it, you can't put no blame on nobody. You can't put no blame on the assistant pastor. You can't put no blame on the lay member. You can't put no blame on the preacher. You can't put no blame on this and then that.
Right.
I'll face nobody's record but my own.
Right, come on.
And that's what we'll do. We'll face nobody's record but our own. And if we were judged, and if we were graded on our service that we've done to God and for God tonight, what kind of grade would we get?
Come on.
I'm talking myself too. What kind of grade? Have we given all? Have we done everything? Have we praised as hard as we could? Have we thanked as hard as we could? Have we kept our mind on Jesus like we should? Have we done it?
Come on, sister.
I face nobody's record but my own.
Amen.
I'm not no big preacher, and I'm not no big long-winded preacher, but if God don't give it to me, you don't get it from me. Because that's one thing I got sense enough to know, you don't play church.
Right.
And you're either in or you're out. You're either living for God or you're hypocriting around.
Amen.
You know, you either trying or you ain't trying.
Right, come on.
And I'm talking about me too, everybody. You know, because, like I said, we'll face nobody's record but our own. And we have to measure up, because there is a day coming that we are going to be graded.
That's right.
We are going to face the Lord Jesus Christ. We are going to face the Heavenly Father. And what will we have to say then? What will we say? If you have your Bibles, I have a couple of scriptures here. Romans 12, 1 and 2. It says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Amen.
Also, we have some more scripture. It says 2 Corinthians 6 and 17. And it says 2 Corinthians 6 and 17. And it says, wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. Oh, wait a minute. I missed that. It says, wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my son and daughter, saith the Lord Almighty. You may be seated. Like I told Miller, I said, I will give them what the good Lord gives me. You know, we'll face nobody's record but our own. And the scripture tells us that we have to be a peculiar people. We are a holy people. We have to be holy. The Bible says, without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. And it says, come out from among them. And people might say, well, what are you going to tell me? You're going to tell me how to act. You're going to tell me how to dress. You're going to tell me where I need to go. No, that's your place. It's your place to get on your knees and say, God, what do I need to do? Where do I need to go? How do I need to act? What do I need to wear? What do I not need to wear? You know, because I'm just going to take you. I've been to the beach, and some of them people down there at the beach, the things they got on ain't decent.
Amen.
If they're hanging out everywhere and everything is hanging out, that ain't decent.
Amen.
You know, the Bible plainly tells us we're supposed to be holy. And if you call yourself a Christian, you need to live like one.
Amen.
You need to act like one. You need to dress like one. You need to live like one.
Come on.
And that's what we have to do. We have to come out from among the world and show them we are different. We do things different. We live different.
Right.
We don't go to their worldly places.
Come on, preach it.
Because we are going to be judged and be nobody's record but our own. And you know, I have people that I know that's different faith. Well, you say, well, they're different faith. They're different faith, and they're going to stand for what they know.
That's right.
Like, I'm going to stand for what I know. When you take somebody that's been in church all their life, they know a bunch.
Yes.
They know a bunch, and they're going to stand for a bunch. They're going to stand for a bunch. And I don't believe in playing church, and nobody else ought not be playing church either. You got to put your whole heart in this.
Come on.
You got to live for Jesus every day. You got to walk for Him every day. You can't get ready to die. You got to stay ready to die.
Right.
We can't get ready to meet Jesus. We've got to stay ready to meet Jesus, because we don't know when He's going to call us home.
Right.
We can be here today or gone tomorrow, because the Bible says life is like a vapor.
Right.
Life is like a vapor. What's a vapor? It's like a puff of smoke, and once you see it in a few minutes, it's gone.
Right.
Your life is like that. You see it here, but next week it could be gone. Tomorrow it could be gone.
Amen.
After a while it could be gone. Just because I'm breathing now don't mean I'm going to be breathing out
tomorrow.
We have to live for Jesus.
Amen.
As if it was our last breath.
That's right.
Day on this earth. We have to be ready to make heaven our home. We don't have time to get ready. We have to stay ready.
Right.
You know, like T.D. Jakes, he says, get ready, get ready, get ready. I say, stay ready, stay ready, stay ready. For the hour you think that Jesus is going to come, we don't know. Nobody's going to do it. That's your last move. When that man was going to come in and rob him, he would have watched and he would have suffered his house not to get broke into. But we don't know. That's why we've got to stay ready,
right.
Stay ready, stay ready, stay
right.
Ready. I'll face nobody's record but my own.
Amen.
We have to live for Jesus every day.
Hallelujah.
We have to walk for him every
Hallelujah.
Day.
Hallelujah.
I'll face nobody's record but my own.
Right.
I can't blame it on you that if I don't obey God. I can't blame it on the pastor if I don't obey God.
Right, come on.
I can't blame it on the singers if I don't obey
right.
God.
Amen.
I'll face nobody's record but my own.
Right.
I'll face nobody's record but my own. I'll stand before God for myself. You'll stand for God for yourself. You can't say, I didn't go to church because my husband didn't want to. You have to have the right to yourself.
That's right.
You have to go whether he goes or
That's
not.
Right. Oh.
You have to keep serving God whether he wants to serve God or not. You've got to keep serving God whether she wants to or
right.
not.
Come on.
I'll face nobody's record but my own. We have to be what God would have us to be. Because like I said, we could be here today and we could be gone tomorrow. We don't know, but I'll face nobody's record but my own. And the Bible plainly tells us to come out from among them. And you say, define that for me. I'm going to define it for you.
Come on.
It's when you get out in business with God
right.
and you say, Lord, I want your will
right.
and not my will.
Right.
That's how you know when you come out from among
right.
them. Because
come
when you want his will, he'll pull you out from
right.
among them. He'll show you what to do. He'll show you what to do. He'll show you what to say. He'll show you when to stay home. He'll show you what to do.
Right.
I'll face nobody's record but my own.
Come on.
And this is a personal walk with the Lord.
That's right.
It is a personal walk. He will teach you. He will guide you. The Bible says, after that the Holy Ghost has come upon
right,
you,
now come on.
You shall receive power to be witnesses.
Right.
But it also tells you that he will lead you and guide you in all paths of the truth.
Right.
The truth. The Bible says, study to show yourself approved. Rightly dividing the word of truth. Okay,
right.
We know the Bible is truth. And then it's up to us to get down and pray and say, Lord, you help me to rightly divide it.
Amen.
And you show me what's for my life. You show me what I need to do.
Come on.
You show me, because I'll face nobody's
Come
record
on,
but my
you.
Own.
Come on.
I'll face nobody's record but my own. And we have personal convictions, like Miller preached on Sunday. But there's also biblical
Right.
biblical convictions.
Right. Come on.
That's for all of us.
That's right.
I'll face nobody's record but my own. I thank the Lord that everybody come out. I thank the Lord we've got a good church.
Amen.
And I praise the Lord and I thank the Lord because he is my Savior. And we have to stay ready to meet
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Because we don't know God's plan on this earth. We know he's got one. And we know we got to try to follow it. But we don't know it down to a T. And like I said, we could be here today and gone tomorrow. That could be God's plan. Because you're here today, you could be gone tomorrow. That could be God's plan.
Amen.
God has a plan.
Amen.
And we have to try to follow
Amen.
It. And the main thing is to have clean hands and a pure heart
Come on.
When we can see God.
Come on.
When he calls us home, we can be ready
right.
to step from this
Come
world
on.
Over to that one and not worry about coming to where we went before. We know that
Amen.
We've got clean hands and a pure heart. We made it to be go and be with Jesus.
Amen.
We won't have to worry about going to hell. If you live by this word and you live by Jesus' Spirit and you live and you don't live by the flesh, you live by the Spirit,
right.
you don't have to worry about going to hell.
Right.
Why?
Amen.
Because the word tells us that if we live for him, he's going to take care of us and he's going to take us home. But let me tell you something, and this goes for me too. Anybody... And you may be in live stream land. If you don't live for Jesus and you're out hypocriting around,
right.
hypocriting around will take you to hell.
Amen.
I don't care who you are. I don't care how many people you know and how high you are up in office and who all you know. Hypocriting around will take you to hell.
Right. Come on.
hypocriting around and taking it.
That's right.
I face nobody's record but my own. And it's up to us. It's up to us to get on our knees. It's up to us to pray.
Right.
It's up to us to fast. It's up to us to draw close
right.
to God for ourselves so we can pray and help others. If I can't help myself, how can I help anybody else?
Amen.
If I can't pray myself and I can't pray over itchy bitchy
yeah.
thing that comes in my life, how can I pray for somebody else?
That's right.
Keep your flesh under subjection. Stay strong in Jesus so you can help somebody else. I have to do that too. Stay strong in Jesus so I can help somebody else.
Hallelujah.
I love the Lord tonight and I praise Him and I thank Him, but I'll face nobody's record
right.
but my own.
Amen.
And if we got a report card for tonight, for this service,
right.
not counting all the other services we've had,
right.
but just this service, what kind of grade would we have? Would we have enough if they took us to court? Could they find enough of Jesus in our life to convict us? Could they find it? Or do we match like the world and they can't tell we're Christian or not a Christian? We ride the fence half the time.
Amen.
Have we got enough of Jesus to convict us in a court of law?
Come on now.
I hope and pray I do.
Come on.
Because I place nobody's record.
Come on.
I love the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. Straight from the gun.
Mm-hmm.
Straight from the gun. The verse right up there in verse 14 it says, but be ye not equally yoked, unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship have the righteous with the unrighteous? That's the word of God. That means you don't associate with the ones that tells the dirty jokes.
Amen.
You don't associate with the ones that says, look at what I've got on my Facebook I want to show you. You don't associate with the things of this world. Because the Bible plainly told us that right here. He said, and what communion have light with darkness? Brother Michael, I believe God's trying to tell somebody you can't stay in the dark all the time because the dark will overcomprehend the light. You got to let your light shine. In other words, you got to get out of that darkness. You got to get out of that dark place that you're staying in and get into the light. Because you can stay in the darkness and guess what? Old doom and gloom will come around. And he'll get you all tore down and get you all just... Oh, I just don't even feel like reading the Word today. I don't even feel like doing this today. I don't feel like doing that today. But she shot straight from the gun. Straight from the gun. Face nobody's record but my own. The Bible said, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling before the Lord. Brother Wayne, a lot of us needs to do that. We got to realize, like she said, well, I like what she said about grading. Amen. What if we got a report card like somebody got here a while back? Just saying. I'm just using him as an example. When we stood before God, Austin, and he says, well, what are you doing with these F's on here? What do you know with this failure on here? Failure. Oh, I asked you to do something for me. Well, I can't do it, God. Well, God, I can't go and talk to somebody right now. I ain't got time. F. Failure. God says, well, I want you to do something for me. Well, God, later on, God, I might do it.
Yes,
Max. Oh, well, she was preaching that. Man, a lot of Christians need to hear that message. What grade would you get? I know a lot of other churches need to hear that. What grade would you get?
Man, that stuck right in my mind right there.
What grade, Brother Wayne? What grade? I was knelt down right here. I was looking in that songbook. Just come to me. Sleep on, sleeping giant. Sleep on. Sleep on, sleeping giant. What are you going to do if God comes and finds you asleep? And then you stand before him and he says, and she just brought it out about the grade card. What kind of grade are you going to get when you stand before God? You get out of the service what you put in the service.
Amen. That's just the facts about it.
If you come in here and you don't want to do nothing, you ain't going to get nothing. But if you come in here and you make an effort and you show God, hey, I want to draw nigh to you. Guess what? God's going to draw nigh to you. You're going to get something out of it. But I think the mother of the church done a good job tonight. I knew I just done a really good job. She's got on some clothes tonight.
She got on that.
I want to know what kind of grade I'm going to get before the Lord.
I want to know what my grade card's going to look like.
See, we get graded at school. When you go to school, you get graded. Did you know you get graded by God too, Matthew? James, you get graded by God?
Yeah.
Brianna, you get graded by God? Lindlin, you get graded by God? Yeah, no one sleep on. You get graded by God.
Over here in 5th chapter in verse 17, it says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature.
Old things are passed away, and behold, all things become new.
Hallelujah. I tell you what, I think that she just blew out of water. She said, oh, I ain't got nothing.
You better be getting something. I said, you'll be all right. You'll get it. Don't worry about it. Guess where she got it at? Right there. Sitting right there. I don't know what title of her message was. I don't know if it was what grade you get or you face nobody's record but your own. But either way, it goes together because the record is what? Keeps a record of everything. Just like you do in school, they keep a record of your grades. Anybody need to pray tonight? Anybody need to talk to the Lord? Say, God, I don't want my report card to look bad. I don't want my grade card to look this way, but I want my grade card to look good.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
name. Now let's give my mother and church another big hand. She ain't here. Hallelujah. She done real good. I'm proud of her.
Amen.
That's because she's my baby. I'm proud of her. How many's glad they've been in the house of the Lord tonight?
Amen.
How many, be honest, you got your toes skinned up tonight? Amen. Hey, take it.
Just say next time, Lord, if it has to get more, let them get more of them. Stick them out there.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Anybody want to testify tonight?
Well, David, I just said everything. I'd rather get my toes
stepped
off
and been up there. That's right. Amen. Amen. There's a lot of them in hell right now saying, man, I wish that I'd listened. I wish I'd have paid attention. But they pushed it off and said, oh. And guess what? They're in hell tonight. They're saying, man, don't come here. Let them skin them toes. Let them step on them toes. You know, there's a lot of Christian people that's died and went to hell because they got mad at a preacher because they got on their toes.
Right.
Sure did.
If they got mad, then they ain't living where they're supposed to be.
That's right.
There you go.
See, sometimes people get mad because of that. I'll be honest. I got mad one time at a preacher. And he come back here and didn't say nothing to me. Just come back here after church. Oh, put his arms around me. He said, brother, I still love you. Man, I just melted. Because I didn't say nothing to nobody about it. But he come right back here to me and put his arms and said, brother, I love you. And the next night, I stuck my toes out and said, just get them.
Get them.
God knows how to get you.
Take every bit of this infection away, God, right now. God, in Jesus' name. Jesus' name we ask you, God, we praise you for it. We thank you for it, God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
And run over.
Praise the Lord. Anybody want to testify?
I want to thank God. I want to thank God for taking my soul and for giving me a family that loves me. I want to praise for waking up and open the scripture this morning.
Amen. Somebody else.
I want to thank God. You know, I just come off a 3-day fast. That's why I've got no mustache, no beard, no nothing. He told me, come to me correctly or don't come to me at all. So, you know, I shaved all this, but had to go back after all this here. You know, I mean, but I want to thank him for what he showed me and what he fed me while I was reading the word during the fast.
Bless him, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else.
I thank the Lord for being here. Thank you for everything he means to me. Thank you for every time he's healed my body. Thank you for every time he's supplied all my needs.
Amen.
He's my life. He's my doctor. He's my lawyer. He is just the lover of my soul. I just praise him and I thank him for everything he's always been to me.
Amen. Somebody else.
I just want to thank the Lord for being here tonight and for him saving my soul and for the family that he's given me. I just want to thank him for what he's going to be doing.
Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else. You made an overcomer.
By the word of the testimony and the blood of the Lamb.
I want to thank the Lord for being here, deciding to thank my film, Holy Ghost, and Mama done a really good job on her message. I'll admit, it got on my toes a little bit, but hey, it's all right. I just read those scriptures 2 days ago myself, so.
Amen. Amen. Somebody else. Amen. Somebody else.
I thank the Lord for being here. I thank you for saving me, sanctifying me, and filling me with the Holy Ghost. I thank you for walking with me throughout the day. And yes, Sister Nora stepped on my toes. I'll be the first to admit because I've been really tired today. I've been on the run all day long, so I should have got up some when they were asking me to. So I apologize, but I thank the Lord for being here, and I thank you for everything he's done for me.
Amen. Somebody else.
You can still get up there and sing.
I'm turning on over now.
It's not over yet. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. Listen.
I want to thank the Lord for what he's shown me twice. He's shown me two different times. Thank you. Along the same thing. I'm able to stare tonight. I seen my brother was walking down the hallway and that place on his leg just fall off on the floor. And this morning, I had a dream with that place. You know how big it is. And we were exercising in my dream. You know, to get something that you want, you've got to do something. And in that dream, that place had gone down to about that size. And I said, thank you, Lord. Now we can see the doctor. And he can have surgery and get the rest of it moved. And when I said in my dream, that thing was flat as glitter. And his whole leg from his hip all the way down to his foot was as long as it ever been. And Connie come running in the bedroom. I was in there crying and real loud. Walker, you know, she was in the living room. I was in the bedroom. And she come there and shouting, what's wrong? What's wrong? I was just thanking God. Because I know it's coming.
Amen.
I'm hoping, but I know it's coming and I'll stand on that word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes. Amen. Somebody else.
He needs to just keep holding on, you know, and I said,
the devil's trying to fight you because he knows he don't have you no more.
That's right.
And y'all just really pray for him. Because I can see the Lord doing work in him. I can see a difference in him. You know, I know what the Lord's done because I see a difference in him.
Amen. Somebody else. If not, we're going to pray over our prayer box. And we're going to dismiss and ask Brother Josh to pray over our prayer box tonight. Let's tell somebody about church Sunday morning. Glad Misty didn't get to go to Smokies because I was wanting to be here this Sunday.
Hey.
So it's your fault.
Or something to them, or
yeah, it's our anniversary.
We're supposed to do on Sunday, but we ain't going to be here Sunday. They ain't at least time.
Here we are.
Yeah.
No, they can't. The Lord changed all that. He had a reason for this. I believe we're going to have something good Sunday morning. I don't know what it's going to be. All I know is just come expecting God to do something.
Well, I know in my dreams, God's been showing me that there's been several up in the front of the church. Everybody in there shouting. So.
I don't know what's going on. I don't know, but God's just like, Sunday morning's going to be something great. I'm looking forward for it. But come to church expecting God to do something.
Amen.
Come excited. Instead of just coming and going. Because Mom will get on to you. She'll grade you. She'll say, God's grading you. Hey, I've been praying for Nora's sisters out here. I got a blessing for you. I ain't going to say which sister because she's got two sisters out there that God can touch. Yeah, but I'm going to talk about it. Yeah. God knows what the need is. Our church is doing good. God is blessing us. The landlord's going to come and he's going to paint this roof over here. I told you the other day we got up there and he's putting this stuff on there, just dobbing them screws. I said, I'll tell you what you need to do. You need to go to Lowe's and get one of them 5 gallon buckets of that sealer and get up there and paint that whole roof because this roof has been up here for umpteen years. And it ain't never had nothing done to it. And it's just starting now to start showing the wear and tear on it. Them metal roofs only can last so long, and then they go on them screws, and the washers around them screws starts wearing out. And you have to replace them and put new ones. So they're going to come up here and they're going to seal it all up. Seal it with that fiber paint so it ain't going to leak then. And they get done with it. And let's pray for our landlord. He needs our prayers. He sure does. Him and his wife needs our prayers. He didn't say nothing about it, but I could tell that sickness is around. I'm telling you, sickness is around. Pray for Adam. He needs our prayers too tonight. He had to go on a wreck that they had, so he didn't get to make it here. He called, told me that time he got home with the truck and stuff, and he got back over to his house, and things had be too late to even make it to church. So God understands that's his job.
Pray for
man, I mean,
also, remember that sin of the family in Scotland?
Yes, remember that family because they'll be burying them tomorrow.
Yeah, I saw.
So remember that family.
Their son went to school by
Sister. We, remember Sister Kathleen? They'll be burying him tomorrow too, won't they?
They buried him
today. Let's remember that family. Pray for Sister Kathleen.
No, she's missing Wallace.
And and she's not doing as good as she should health-wise, and she needs our touch,
prayers.
Our prayers, and she needs us to really get a hold of God for her. I mean, she's done lived her life, and she knows that any time that God's ready to call her home, she's ready to go. She's lived the life, Brother Wayne. If anybody I wanted to follow after, that'd be the one that I would want to follow after, is Sister Kathleen Sykes. And remember Sister Larimore, she's on up in age, but she's still going. She ain't gave up. She ain't retired. She's still preaching the word. And Sister Kathleen's the same way, still preaching that word. We got a lot of preachers out there that ain't hit 60 and they done retired from preaching. And they're done up in their 80s and they're still preaching the word.
If you're preaching the word now, you're still preaching the word when you go home.
That's right. Amen. We're going to have Josh come. We're going to anoint this prayer box. It's not been anointed at all. We're just going to pray over it and ask God to touch it. Anybody that wants to pray, bless Heavenly Father, Lord God, as we come. Lord, you see these things and these requests. Lord God, you see each and every one. God, you see the loss. God, you see the sickness. God, you see the finances. Lord God, you see the spiritual needs. God, you see this, the ones, God, that just needs a touch from you, God. God, we just pray, God, that you would move upon them right now, God, in the name of Jesus. God, as we pray over this prayer box, God, you move upon these people. Lord, move upon, God, move upon the lost. Move upon those that's got cancer in them, Lord. God, we ask right now, God, in your son's precious name. God, we praise you for it, God. We thank you for it, God. We ask it, God. You said you sent your word and your word healed me. God, we're sending the word right now. God, in Jesus' name, you said we're two or three. You don't touch any one thing, God, it shall be done. God, we're agreeing right now. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Over here on the wall is a sign up sheet for the Easter play. Also, we need some Easter candy and some eggs be brought in for Easter. So I figured I'd go ahead and say something now. I'm going to say something again Sunday. Because I mean, Easter, man, will be here just before you know it. First day of April. So, we need some candy to fill eggs. Need some people to help fill eggs. And we're also, we're going to try to have an Easter dinner. We just ain't decided where we're going to do it at yet. We don't know what the weather's going to be like. It could be snowing Easter. So, just keep all that under your hat. And remember. Next Thursday night's youth service, Brianna.
Wednesday night's youth meeting.
And if you ain't being good, your mama tells me you ain't being good, well, then we're going to get somebody else to do it.
Wednesday night's youth meeting at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, what?
Wednesday night
at 6 o'clock's youth meeting out here at the church. We're going to be out here and we're going to practice some songs with y'all. So, how many is excited? There are people out there on live stream like, man, this church is, what happened to this church tonight? I think, man, did they go to sleep on us or what? Well, we want to tell people out there on live stream, we're still here, we're still alive, and we love you. If you need prayer for your body, you need prayer for anything, just give us a little comment down below and tell us what you need and we'll pray over it. If you need to be prayed for a sickness, write it on there. We'll pray for it.
Hey, we're listening on Glasgow's election platform homepage. On the church of study at the bottom under non-denominational. They need you to hold those things on there.
I don't know how you come up here and tell them that. Because I can't remember all that you just said.
If you get a hold of you, go to the website.
If
you need to get a hold of us, you can go to the Glasgow homepage. EPP. Their church page. And they can find us
down at the bottom.
Under undenomination. Under
non-denominational.
There you go.
It can be found under the non-denominational link on that page.
Amen. I'm getting older. Amen. Well, I don't want to narrate no play anyway. Well, let's all stand tonight. I'm going to ask our assistant pastor to dismiss us.
Our gracious Father in heaven tonight, God, we thank you, Lord, for your love and your mercy, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, for the word tonight, God. We ask you, Father God, to go with each and every one of us,
yes,
Lord.
Jesus.
Be with us, Lord God, the remainder of this week, Lord. Help us, Lord, to keep you upon our minds.